mercy on us, O God, according to your unfailing love, according to your great compassion, blot out our transgressions, wash us thoroughly from our iniquity, and cleanse us from our sins, creating us pure hearts, O God, and renew steadfast spirits within us. Do not cast us away from your presence, or take your Holy Spirit from us. Restore to us the joy of your salvation, and grant us willing spirits to sustain us. Open our lips, O Lord, and our mouths will declare your praise. Let us bow in prayer. Heavenly Father, O God, today as we start our journey with our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, a journey in the days leading up to when we, O Lord, celebrate Easter. Father in heaven, a journey where we observe, O Lord, how our Lord and Saviour was sacrificed and when he died upon that cross. Father in heaven, as we, O Lord, begin this journey, we seek your strength, we seek your wisdom, we seek your guidance. We ask you to forgive us and to cleanse us and to create in us clean hearts as we meditate upon your word this evening. As we meditate upon your word today, in the name of Jesus, amen.
The first scripture reading is taken from Joel chapter 2 verses 12 to 14. Yet even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. Rend your hearts and not your clothing. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishing. Who knows whether he will not turn and relent, and leave a blessing behind him, a grain offering and a drink offering for the Lord your God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen. The second scripture reading is taken from Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 to 6. Beware of practicing your piety before others in order to be seen by them, for then you have no reward from your Father in heaven. So whenever you give alms, do not sound a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be praised by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be done in secret, and your Father, who sees in secret, will reward you. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God for his word. Amen.
As we begin our journey with our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, in these weeks before Good Friday, when we culminate this period of Lent, as we remember God's grace, mercy and love shown as God's only Son, Jesus, was crucified for our sins. As we move on to Easter Sunday, when we celebrate the resurrection of Christ, the resurrection that lifts us from a life of sin to the forgiveness that allows us passage to a glorious life eternal in heaven. We begin today with looking firstly at God's call to his people to return to him. The prophet Joel issued a call declaring that God is gracious, merciful, slow to anger, loving and forgiving. Joel states that God does not want to punish those that he loves. However, he calls for our faith to be strong, that as people return to God, repentant, sorrowful, and fasting, that they must trust the Lord to see how he blesses us. That is, it is the will of God, and we are called to trust him and to turn to him. That with faith, that God is loving and wants his people to return to him. All of us can return and look forward to what the Lord will do for them. It was so at the time of the prophet Joel, around 800 years before Christ, some 2800 years ago. It is so today on this Ash Wednesday. God is calling us to return to him, to seek forgiveness, to seek him even with fasting. God is calling us to trust him today, that with expectation, belief, and faith, we can trust the Lord, our Lord, to deliver us. And how that is seen in our lives relies on the will of God. He is our Father in heaven, knowing what he has in store for us. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." It is his grace, and it is how we are saved. Therefore, we must trust him and wait, as he strengthens us with patience, for how and when we will experience his blessings. Psalm 27:14 says, "Wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he will strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord." Of interest in the reading, and this is often misquoted, Joel is saying to the people to tear their hearts, tear apart all that is wrong in their minds, tear apart all their wrong ideas, the misconceptions that they have about God. Yes, rend or tear your hearts and not your garments or clothes. As we tear apart our hearts, it is an act of retrospection to know where we need to seek forgiveness, to change, to come before God. The thought of tearing gives an indication of separation. Therefore, we separate ourselves from sin, from what we know that is wrong in how we live. To separate ourselves from all that we know that is not pleasing to our God. It is the way we ourselves reflect on our lives during this period of Lent. When we look deeply at our lives in Christ and seek to make lasting change. Change that continues even after Easter Sunday. Yes, my friends, to rend, meaning to tear our hearts and not our clothes, as we fast and pray. Another noteworthy point is that Joel is saying that God does not want to punish his people. We know this today as we experience the grace of God, as we are forgiven from all sins because God in his mercy sent Jesus to die that we may live. So, as we begin this journey through Lent, let us look carefully at our lives, rend or tear apart our hearts and our minds. We come before God and seek him as we inspect who we are and see where we must change for God's honor and his glory. We must know where we are to know where we want to go. We must know where we are to know where we want to go. We must know our state as Christians, to know where we need to be forgiven, and then to allow God's grace to cause us to become stronger in faith. There, thus, as we seek God, we trust, we believe, we expect, and we wait. It is our faith that God will deliver us. As the prophet Joel highlighted, it is God's grace and his love. Now, some guidelines from Jesus regarding our service to him. In Matthew 6, as we read, we can see three aspects of worship being mentioned. One, the act of righteousness, such as fasting. Two, almsgiving or charity. And three, praying. And in all three, Jesus calls us to do these in secret before God, who will know what we do, and not before our relatives, friends, and others, and sometimes people that we do not even know. It is to seek your reward from God and not to seek praises from others. Christ promises us to reward us for our service to him. Therefore, we need to trust and show that we have faith that God knows and God bestows. This is similar to the urging from the prophet Joel, as we read today, that do as we are called and trust God for his answers to our prayers. It is a journey during Lent, but it is a journey that we continue through our lives. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now, the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, be with us both now and forevermore.